So this video I'm going to discuss about the antidote to the drivers. That is again a transaction analysis concept which I discussed in the previous video. So if you missed the previous video on drivers, please do watch it. I've given the link in the description. So after watching that video, I'm sure you would be aware of what is the driver, which is like, you know, driving your everyday behavior and predicting your personality patterns in your everyday life, and which may put you on the path of failure also and can make you fail eventually in your marital relationship as well as in your corporate works. So when you know these are the negative consequences of these drivers, then you should be really aware of how do I control it or manage it so that it does not have any disastrous consequences in my life. So first, let's go to the first driver, that is the pleasing others driver. So now I've discussed everything about pleasing others, I'm not going to go back to it again. So let's see what is antidote. So as the name goes, instead of pleasing other people, we call it as allowers. For all the drivers, the antidote, we call the key term used by in transaction analysis concept, that is allowers. So what will allow you to cut through this driver is please yourself. So instead of putting others' need in front of you, or you know, even before you, prioritizing others, do prioritize yourself, respect yourself and try to please yourself. So what would I get out of this? Because we are sticking to these kind of primitive driver behaviors which we learned in our childhood for some payoffs. Always we get something out of it and feel like I'm okay only when I'm, you know, involving myself in these kind of behavior. The moment you're trying to challenge it, you'll feel the uneasiness. And it's okay, fine, initially it'll be there because it's like you're reprogramming your brain. You're like connecting a new circuit all along. So it will cause some kind of uneasiness, but don't worry, you're in the right path. So what we can do is try to, you know, please yourself by listening and attending to your needs. So eventually what you will understand is you will stop feeling, you know, blaming others, or, you know, feeling resentful of others that I've done so much for them, they've never reciprocated. Now that you're going to prioritize yourself, you're not going to go out of the way and engaging yourself in activities, some activities which is going to please others. You will be definitely taking care of others, that will not be stopped. But then that particular extra things what you do or overdoing things to please other people will not be done anymore. So in long run, you'll be feeling a sigh of relief that okay, no more that people are like victimizing me, and you'll start feeling good about yourself also. So just learn about this, how it's going to have a disastrous consequences of a life. Understand it, explore yourself, retrospect about how, what kind of negative impact it brought into your life. Only then you'll get the motivation to challenge this driver in you, that is pleasing others, which is a very dangerous drive. So when you're going to please others, you'll have a relationship problem definitely. So if you could relate to what I'm saying, try to put yourself in the path of pleasing yourself first. Okay, attend to you and be listening to your needs and keep yourself happy. For this, you need two things, that is one is self-confidence and one more skill, that is assertiveness. So I've talked a lot about assertiveness and how to develop this, and also about self-confidence in another video. So I've given the link to those two videos also, so you can watch it and try to come out of this driver, that is please others. Okay, so let's go to the next driver, that is be perfect. So what could be the antidote for this? It's simple, isn't it? So we have to learn to accept ourselves even when we fail, even when we make mistakes. So about this again, I put a video about, you know, how you should embrace the mistakes and failures and learn from it and take it as a learning experience, another video about with the link also given. So people who find yourself with this driver, that is be perfect, please do watch that particular video which I've given in the link to come out of it, and some more handy tips I can give here itself in this video. For people who are having this tendency, be perfect, you may not allow yourself to, you know, lose control, and you feel like everything should be in my control, and eventually what you'll feel is like you feel so much anxiety and stress. Maybe you will do the things, you will achieve it, but at what expense? What is the cost you're paying for it? Just think for a while. Anxiety, stress, and, you know, feeling that of dissatisfaction also, even though you have put so much of time, effort into it, you invested a lot, but the outcome, is it really worth it? So, and also the unfortunate news is, if you're going to be perfect, the quality of the outcome is going to be compromised, because you're a people with so much of quality. But the truth is, when you're going to be perfect, the time you're going to take to complete the task is going to be extended. You may procrastinate, and finally the outcome also will not be as good, and which is not delivered on time is also not good. So think about these consequences, how it is going to have on your life, impact your life. Then you will get the motivation to come out of this, be perfect. Somewhere you learned it in your childhood and time to shed it. And you can watch the videos which I've given in the link as in the description. Okay, so please do watch it and try to strive against this, be perfect. So all the best for that. So we'll go to the next drive. Hurry. So just hurry up. For these people, what could be the antidote? That is allower, that is slow down. So you could see these kind of people in the traffic, you know, always keeping their hands on the horn and seem so tensed and not able to unwind at all, and also eating very quick and doing everything fast, so which I already explained in the previous video. So for you, the advice would be to slow down. And it's not that easy if you could follow this, you know, whatever I recommend to practice, because you may have been practicing this for a very long time in your life, let's say like 10 years, 20 years, depending on the whatever age group you are in. So your mind will resist initially, but just retrospect about what are the consequences you had and what are the benefits you are going to reap when you are going to change. Just imagine if you are going to eat slowly, your digestion will improve actually, and you may even get weight loss. So a lot of benefits to when you think to come out of it. You people have to slow down and relax and de-stress, because these hurrier people have this sense of failure and feel like when they are even resting for a while or just sitting for 5 minutes also, they feel it's a sin. Oh my God, I didn't do this. So I feel like a failure, and they can't relax at all. So it's the whole idea of this life is to enjoy each and every minute of it. So try to savor life and don't hurry up. You just have to slow down and enjoy each and every piece of life, and in a way it is like it's going to present it to yourself. So you need to really de-stress for this. So this is the recommendation for it. You can even watch videos of how to de-stress. Okay, so the next we'll go to the next driver. Next driver is about be strong. So this is especially for men, I said. So whenever this particular driver sets in, people don't even express their emotion. They feel that they cannot be satisfied. For what could be the allure or antidote is just express yourself. Okay. So there's nothing wrong which is going to happen, because these people fear rejection. So that is the reason they don't express. They actually try to listen to others' needs and, you know, try to satisfy all others' needs. But then they find it so difficult and overwhelming to express themselves. They feel like, it cannot be understood or validated by another person. And their needs can never be met, because they also attract such people into their lives. So all these drivers subconsciously will, you know, eventually try to fail the opposite of those behaviors. So please be aware of it. It's like a trick your mind plays on you. So for people who are in this driver, that is be strong. All you have to do is try slowly. Whenever you're going to decide, keep down your thinking brain or the logic brain and try to think in an emotional way. Okay, you have to feel it. And when you're going to put the feeling button on, then you know, like, I can also express something. You can find someone who's trustworthy and who's loyal, who can actually listen to your needs, and you can actually listen to your emotions. And when you feel like you're accepted the way you are, then you can definitely overcome this driver. So all the best for that again. And lastly, we see the driver on try hard. So these people, what happens to try hard people, it may look so positive. All they're doing is just trying hard, right? But the problem with these try hard drivers is they don't eventually achieve things. So again, they end up feeling like a failure, because they try really hard, and because of putting a lot of hard work, they won't actually finish the task. So they get bored because they're going to redo things a lot of times. So they may actually do not finish the task and they come out of it. So the antidote or the allure for them is to do it. Just do it. So you need not try with all the difficult work you need to do. Just do it. And once you complete the task, whatever you're given, then you'll feel like you've really achieved it. And that will reinforce you to further engage in other tasks as well. So it's not always that hard work which pays. You can also just do it in whatever way possible to complete the task. So you have to try these recommendations after being aware of your drivers. And these antidotes are not very easy. So word of caution is, even though I'm telling very easily, this is the antidote for this is the antidote for all these five drivers. The first difficult step to be aware. Now that you're all aware of your drivers, maybe you may have one or two prominent drivers within all of us, right? So when you could understand that and then you retrospect on it, the next step is to apply these antidotes in terms of behaviors. For example, again revisiting one of the drivers when I told about hurry up. People who are, you know, in the traffic jam and your mind voice says that you just go fast, you just go out to put on the accelerator button or give that sound horn. That time you just say, let me relax, let me just wind down, let me listen to a music. It may be very difficult for you, but if you could follow all these procedures, what I'm telling you, for over a period of time, that becomes a habit and you're successfully rewired your network, the neuron network. And from now on, you'll be free from these drivers which has been like dictating you all the terms and putting you in the path of failure in relationships as well as in health, as well as in your professional activities as well. So now that you are aware and then able to apply the antidote, definitely you'll be living the way you really wanted to live, isn't it? So please share your experiences of what your drivers were and how it was like giving a lot of negative impact in your life, and did you really put these antidotes into practice and what was the result? So for more interesting things, I'm expecting a lot of interesting comments for this video. So please comment it, and if you really find this video is interesting, and if you really think it's going to be useful for other people, do share this video. And do not forget to subscribe to my channel for just watching all this TA series videos. And moreover, I'm going to discuss about two more interesting concepts in transaction analysis in the videos to follow in the coming weeks. That is about your life scripts and also games people play. So very interesting concept, and you'll be surprised to know that you are also playing all such games in your life without your knowledge, which is going to be ruining your relationship and transactions, that is a communication in your family life as well as in your work life. So please look forward to these videos and have a very nice day. Take care. Bye.